Come on, right here. Pay attention to me. I don't know. There's nothing right there. Why are you focusing on that?
Oh, there I am. There I am.
Shoo. Shoo. there's a lot of good stuff. I'm learning a lot of stuff that I didn't know. And listen, let me tell you one thing. There's nothing wrong with being wrong. There's nothing wrong with being ignorant. What is wrong is when you don't know that you're ignorant. When you're ignorant, you need to educate yourself. You need to learn. You can't, or if you want to stay ignorant, then don't have an opinion. Just state that you don't know and you don't have an opinion. Don't be ignorant and then have harsh opinions. It doesn't make sense. That's not how society should function. So I spent time educating myself and formulating opinions. And there's a lot of good stuff going on right now. I think that although there is wild, just protest, or no, I should say the riots and the looting, there's so much good going on. I feel like we are being united. And I like to remind people that this is not a white versus black, war battle. We're not, it's not white versus black. That's not what this is all about. This is good versus evil. And racism is evil. To hate other people because of the color of their skin, because of where they're from, that is wrong, that is evil, that is sin. And that is the issue at hand. The evil are using racism as their tool for destruction. You know, we need to do everything that we can for justice, because justice is good. That is what all the protests are about. It's for justice. You know, people shouldn't be able to get away with murdering people because they are police. And I 100% support the protests. I 100% support it. I do not encourage looting. I'm not condoning looting. But I will say this, and this is probably an unpopular opinion, but it's real, and it's a hard concept to understand. It is that peaceful protests are easy to ignore. The looting and the rioting and the destruction, although I'm not encouraging or condoning, I would not be a part of it, and I would try to stop it. It may help bring peace. It may help encourage change. You know, it's just like George Floyd. If someone asked the question, do you think it would be good for some, do you think we need somebody to die for change to occur? We would be like, no, we don't want someone to die. We don't want someone to be murdered. But in this case, it happened. And although George Floyd's murder and death was unfortunate and sad, and it has encouraged change, and we are here because of that tragedy. So although the looting is a tragedy, it may encourage change. And that's probably an unpopular opinion. A lot of people don't feel like that. I know I've had conversation with my parents about it, and their opinion is, what if it was our house that was destroyed? It gets tough. It's like, it is what it is. If good comes out of it, and the world changes, and it might help end racism, or get, you know, take the next step, then it is what it is. And I would hope that people come and support us and help us out if our house was burned down, you know? So because I feel like this, because, you know, I'm not condoning or encouraging looting, but it is happening and we can't control that. I'm for the protests. I want to help out. I want to do my best. Sorry, I'm getting passionate in my voice, and I'm getting about to start using my normal voice. But because I am pro-protest, but the looting is going to happen because there are people that don't know how to control themselves, that let their emotions get the best of them. I want to support local businesses that have been affected, because I would hope that the people would do the same for me. So because ways that somebody can profit off of crime, that they can give people years in jail, profit off of them. You know, just maybe, I think eight years for possession of marijuana, that is ridiculous. And people are making profits off of those people. That is wrong. That is not protecting and serving our communities. People in power should be held accountable just as much as I am and just as much as black people are. I don't think blacks should be held to a higher standard than me. It doesn't make sense. But they are talking about disbanding the entire police in Minneapolis. And for me, I don't live in Minneapolis, but I feel like I'm just interested. You know, go ahead and do it. Go ahead and disband the police, and let's see what happens. You know, if that's what their society wants and feels like is best for them, let them do it, and we'll watch and see what happens. You know, my hypothesis would be that crime rates increase, but let's test it out and see what happens. If it goes wrong, then we'll go back. If it goes, you know, if there is success, then we can build on that. It is okay to be wrong, but when you're wrong, things need to change. And this is a neat opportunity to maybe try to change some things. And let me just explain. My brother-in-law is a police officer. I personally have a difficult time understanding why people hate all police. But I'm trying to understand. My friend described it as, you know, good police officers are marbles. And, you know, there are bad police officers, believe it or not. You know, we've seen them. And that police officer is a snake. And you put all these marbles and the snake in a bag. Are you going to reach in the bag? No, you're not. Because all it takes is you reaching in that bag and picking up that snake, and it's going to bite you. And you're done for. So I guess I understand. Although all police officers don't deserve the hate. They don't deserve it. Maybe during this time, the hate that they are receiving will encourage change. And once the change occurs, and things get better, and there'd be no reason to hate the police. I do not hate the police. I can understand why people do. It's very dangerous to think in absolutes. Like saying, all police are evil, all police are racist, all blacks are bad, all blacks are this, all whites are this, all whites are that. But that's the way our brains think. We like to categorize things, and trying to stop thinking like that is difficult. But I just ask people to challenge themselves and not think like that, because that kind of thinking is what got us to this place in the first place. And guys, if I say something, you know, I'll probably say something in this video that might not come out correctly, but understand that I'm trying to have this conversation in love. My intentions are pure. You know, I'm not trying to hate on any group. I'm just trying to understand everything that's going on. I'm still learning. So, you know, if I do say something or it comes out kind of odd, give me some grace. Let me know. But I'm having this conversation in love, and maybe you can learn something from me, and I'll definitely learn something from you. Craziest experience with racism that I've had two experiences. So the first one was in high school. noticed, and we might not see it every day. You know, I'm from a suburb of Columbus. Half of, you know, probably more than half of my friends growing up were minorities. You know, I didn't see racism like that. But depending on what community you came from, it's going to be more prevalent than others. So I just want to let people know that it is still out there. I've seen it, and I live in a suburb. And I know I've seen videos that they're all coming up now where people, I don't know, I think it was some guy in a high position. He's tearing down Black Lives Matter posters. And some girl's like, Black Lives Matter. And he's like, not to me, they don't. And this is a leader of their community. There's just crazy stories coming out like this. And you just can't, I can't believe that people can have such disregard for human life. Some of my friends' families, they've gotten in arguments with their parents, or not parents, but with their extended families because they believe that blacks are ruining America. It's like, this stuff is coming out, and I've been so blind to it, you know, and I had to educate myself, and that's okay. I apologize for not being so aware of it until now that all this has had to happen for me to speak out and finally do something. But at least it has happened. My camera's gonna die here soon. I could probably ramble about this for hours. I had so much stuff I wanted to talk about, but we're already sitting at like probably 25 minutes or something. My camera's been on for 30 minutes. Guys, I love y'all. I care about all of you guys. I hope that we can have a really good conversation in the comments. Now is the time to really show people love. Show people that you care about them. Do what you can. If you have money to give, give. If you have time to give, give that time. But during such a sensitive time, and a time where you can have such a big impact and be part of the movement, it's really, really cool. So, guys, I'm gonna sign off here. I'm gonna go continue support raising. Again, if you want to hear more about my ministry, I haven't gone into too much detail about what I do, but if you want those details, shoot me an email.